Welcome to another haul video. Yes, now I was planning on doing this yesterday, but I got back so late and I basically spent a lot of time when I got home last night from New York unpacking and making my bed because my mom decided to my bedroom was gone without telling me because she think it needed to be clean, so who am I to argue with that? Okay, now unlike last time I did one of these hauls, which was back in May, I didn't get any movies this time. Nope. Didn't go to Best Buy. Didn't go to, like, any Best Buy. Basically, it's all comic shops. Well, at least stuff that sell graphic novels. Okay. Now, I went to 5 different stores over the course of, like, 6 days. Now, this first shop I went to on Thursday. The first day I got to New York. Because I arrived in New York on Wednesday. And I decided to relax as soon as I got there. Of course, people have missed my videos. Now, I did manage to, while I was up in New York, I did manage to get all my videos done and all on time. Yes. Yes, I did. Yes, I know that my last video I did was 2 days ago because basically I was so tired from the long flight and the long drive home. It's an hour and a half from the airport I went to the Atlanta airport. It's an hour and a half driving home. So it was so exhausting. So that's the only reason we're going to do this. Okay, now, like I said, I went here on my second day. On Thursday, this was the only place I went to. It was actually a couple places I went to that I actually spent money on it. Now, as for how much money I spent, one, I will kind of hint at basically how much I spent per place. This one, basically, a lot of them are basic, with the exception of like one place, I actually spent around $50 for this stuff. But as for the exact amount, I'm not going to say. Okay, first place I went to is called Sandy's Dugout. It's a comic shop in Hershey. I've been there several times. Great place to go. It's a great environment. It's a very small shop, per se. Though, size-wise, basically, the comic shop where I live is bigger. Yes, it's a lot bigger because it's got more than one room. Here, just straight in. The one thing I didn't like about it was the fact that you had to wear a mask to go in there. It's New York. What do you expect? Because of bullcrap politics up there. Here, don't have to worry about that. Okay, now, as for in the case of what I got there, this is the bag they gave me, I got these following books. Excuse me. I got the Digital First book, Cloak and Dagger, Shades of Grey. Yeah, I'm looking forward to doing this, reading this and reviewing it. Yep. That's one of the books I got. That was done by Dennis Hopeless. We have Thor, Volume 2, Prey. Yeah, I'm a big fan of Donny Codis, and I love the guy's work, so want to continue viewing it. I had the first trade from The Joker. Yeah, one of two trades, of course, this one too, from DC Infinite Frontier. Yeah, The Joker, written by James Tenney of the Four, a guy who I've actually met at Comic-Con. Yeah, I'll be talking about this in the comic core in the future. And the other one I got is the first trade to collect issues from the current volume of Suicide Squad by Robbie Thompson. Yes, here's a fun fact for you. I have reviewed every single volume released for Suicide Squad, released in Chain Payback, except for Volume 3. Yes, the Rise of Flag miniseries, done by the original writer, John Ashford. I have not read that. I've read it, yes, but I haven't reviewed it yet. I might review it in the future. But this is actually very recent. This volume started just this year, like back in March. Yes, March. Yes, I'll be getting more to that when I get to stuff. Well, other stuff anyways. All right. Now, didn't go to a comic shop on Friday. It was basically I went to a couple different places. I didn't buy anything per se. I went to Salvation Army. And I went to, supposedly was going to go to a comic shop, but they were closed. For no reason, despite the fact my cousin and I decided to go there. And closed up tight. Despite the fact that online it said it was open. Yeah, they need to update that. Not the first time I've seen something like that. This also happened, believe it or not, from a comic shop here in town. Not the same one I really go to nowadays. That closed up all of a sudden. It just basically closed up with no warning at all. Last time I was in there, there was no mention of close up. It seems like a pretty, despite the fact that I've heard from other people about that shop, I'm not going to name the name of the shop, but apparently from her, from some people who went there, besides me, the people who I talked to, they were pretty nice to me somewhat. They kind of yell at me a couple times over disagreement with me or something. But otherwise, though, I got along with him. It was okay relationship, per se, between customer and employee there. It was okay. But they closed up for some apparent reason. And apparently, they make a lot of their money via Magic the Gathering. Yes, as a matter of fact, they sell comic books. The only problem with the shop was they didn't have much for graphic novels. No, seriously, they very rarely had any. Like, I found some. The comic shop basically is, that's actually a little bit closer to my house than that one is, which that's called Honor and Glory. That one has a great collection of graphic novels and a good collection of comic books, too. And unlike the other shop, this one actually has recent released comics, which I was so happy with that. As next time we go in there, I don't know it because, but if everybody was after me, all these graphic novels, a lot of them. All right. Then on Saturday, I went to 4 different stores. This one, it was going to be almost $100 for 5 trade paperbacks. But then I said, put 2 of them back, and those were a Catwoman and Black Cat trades. Those I will get in the future, but not right now. So basically, unlike in the case of Shuggy Zugout, where I got 4 trades. This one only got 3. Yeah, and the bag is kind of partially ripped. What did I get? I got the 3rd and final trade for Patsy Walker, aka Hellcat. Yes, the final trade for this one. Looking forward to doing this one when I get a chance. Yeah, that'd be one series that I actually enjoyed when it was coming out. I'm actually quite surprised what ended. I also got Black Mumbo. Yep. A character I recently talked about when I talked about my I think it was the 3rd trade for Ninjak. Yeah, I was so happy to get my hands on this. You know, my favorite writers, Colin Bunn. My mom was not a fan of the artwork, per se. It looked very blah to her. Yeah, she was not a fan of the artist at all. Yeah, and not a fan of the character. This other thing, I liked character Black Mumbo. Yes, I'll talk about more about her when I talk about it in the comic corner. And the last trade I got, and I was so happy to get my hands. This is also Robbie Thompson, believe it or not. And it's the 2nd and last trade for Venom Space Knight. Yep, I'm so happy to get my hands on this. And here's a little fun story about this one, which I may go into again. I tried for this book on Amazon. Out of print. For a book that came out, oh, how long was this book? Well, it must be about 5 years ago, I think it was. Yeah, 5 years ago, this trade came out, and it's already out of print. Yeah, the 2nd trade of Venom Space Knight. Alright, now, in the case of next one, The Strand, the world's largest bookstore. 4-story store, and I got these on the 2nd floor, believe it or not. Yes, they also have basements, New York. I got the first trade for Black Magic by Greg Rucka and Nicola Scott. This one was looking forward to more hands on this one than Old Guard because I love this series so much. And I'll be talking about this in the future. Basically, all these trades talk about comic corners, but I want to show these off here. X-Men of War, Volume 3. Volume 2, actually, Enter Ninjak. This one could be so excited to read. Yep. And we have these next two are actually from the start of the most recent runs for these two series. We have the first trade of Shadow Man. I believe this is the start of the most recent run for the series, not the original run. This is fairly recent. Yeah, this is the first to collect issues for the most recent run for Shadow Man. Yeah, he's my personal favorite characters from Valiant. My favorite character overall is Bloodshot. I love Bloodshot, both in the original continuity and the current one. I would say number two is probably a tie between Ninjak and Exo. Yes. And this guy right here, number three. Right. Yep. And yes, I do consider characters like Faith and Livewire be up there as my favorite characters from Valiant. As for favorite female character from Valiant, I would probably say it's Faith. Because, one, I'm a fan of basically the writer who wrote her ongoing series. And two, she's a fun character. Now, she's a plus-size superhero. Not really a big issue with that. I kind of wish that the character would lose a little bit of weight. You might be thinking I'm a hypocrite, basically, myself. But, yeah. I mean, she's a fun-loving character. And plus, she loves comics. Yep. My second favorite character is Livewire. Yes, the woman who one of the only female superheroes in Valiant, and she had a sexual relation with frickin' Ninjak. Next up it is Divinity 2. I love Divinity, so I got the first book, so why not get the second one? Now, I described the first series as beautiful. It is frickin' gorgeous. I love Divinity. It's my favorite series from Valiant. It's shocking, though, there's no Divinity 4. Yep. And it's all about Soviet cosmonauts. Yep. Alright. This one I got from a place actually next door to Strand. Excuse me. Called Forbidden Planet. And this store actually spent the most because one of the trades basically was about $25. Alright. First up we have Day of Vengeance. Yes, a trade that came out about over a decade ago. I'd say about 15 years ago this came out. Yeah, I was actually quite surprised. I got this book for dirt cheap. I got this book for $7.99. Yeah, the thing about the trades I got from the Strand, before I talk about more about the Forbidden Planet, these trades are dirt cheap. Like, wow. Like this trade here, probably about $14. $7.50. This trade, $9.99. Which, that's... Well, yeah, apparently this price was $14.99. For Rye, $9.99. And for Divinity, $7.50. Yeah, that's why I love going to the Strand. Because, Black Magic, this was $9.99 as well. Yeah, one of the reasons why I like going to the Strand, the trades there are so dirt cheap. And this one was the only one at Forbidden Planet that was cheap. Everything else, epic card price for them. Here's more Valiant. Rapture, a crossover between Shadow Man and Ninjak. I am so looking forward to reviewing this. Especially since it takes place between the third and fourth trades. This crossover, which I'm looking forward to. This is done by Matt Knott, the guy who wrote Ninjak. I love his run for Ninjak. If I ever did a ranking video of my favorite series from Valiant, that series would make it. Next we have the very first trade of the Ben Reilly Scarlet Spider series by Peter David. Yes, I finally got into basically going into the near future reviewing this. Despite the fact I'm reviewing a few issues of the actual series as of a crossover next in my 2 videos from now. And my last trade I got from Forbidden Planet is Detective Comics Volume 6 Road to Ruin, which, believe it or not, is the final trade that collects issues from Peter Tomasi's run for Detective Comics. Yes, it's the last one, and this actually also is the most recent issues released prior to Infinite Frontier. Alright, now as for the final store I went to, Barnes & Noble. Yes. Now this was a Barnes & Noble that is 5 stories, and I had to go to the 4th floor in order to get these, and I like the graphic novel section a little better than where I am because it's a little more basically there per se. Okay, so first up I got was Thor Volume 3 Revelations. Alright, here's another kind of final trade. We have X-Men by Jonathan Hickman, Volume 3. This technically is the last trade to collect issues from Jonathan Hickman's run for X-Men. even though there is technically one more issue, but that's probably the Hellfire Gala crossover. These issues came out just after X of Swords, which is an excellent cross. I love that one. This one took me really long. I thoroughly enjoyed it. And the last trade I got was Swamp Thing, Volume 1, The Becoming. Yeah, the first trade that collects issues from this run, collects the first four issues of this 16-issue run. Yeah, apparently it's a 16-issue maxi series. They've included Future State Swamp Thing. I'm looking forward to viewing this. Yeah, it's one of a couple books that do. That's the kind of Future State books. The other one is Suicide Squad. But I view those in the future. But I do have a comic book coming up. The next video I'm going to do is going to be a movie review. Yes, a movie review, which I'm looking forward to basically discussing this movie. Especially as I watched some in-flight, it was in-flight movie I watched on the way back from New York. Okay? But in the case of my trip overall, after I went there, for the next day was the Christmas party, which that was 2 days ago. X Christmas party, it was pretty enjoyable, despite the fact the house is kind of cold. Yeah, when I went there, it's in Connecticut, this house. And I was stepping with this, and I was kind of surprised this happened. And pretty much anyone watching me was like, really? You passed by this place on the way to a Christmas party? Yes. I passed by WWE headquarters in Stamford. Yes. We actually drove by to that place. Like, I knew exactly what it was just by looking at it. I've seen this place in pictures. I've seen footage of this place. Never seen this place in person. Now, from what I've heard, the building does not offer any tours, despite the fact I'm sure, really sure, that Vince make a ton of money on tours of his own office. Like, Irish people love to see the office, the WWE headquarters, it's Vince McMahon's office, Triple H's office, maybe not Stephanie McMahon's office per se, because, well, even though she's good for branding, but she's basically a terrible person on TV because of her terrible persona. The TV studio stuff. Well, I have heard they're building a new building, but this is the actual WWE headquarters. In case you're curious, though, you might be asking, did I see the 999 flag on top of the building? No, I didn't. It was not there. I didn't see it there. I've seen pictures of the 999 flag because of the WWE Network. My guess is the reason why they took it off because it's on Peacock now. The flag I saw on top, I saw the American flag there, and I saw the WWE flag there. The one that had the current logo, which is basically a logo they unveiled. Believe it or not, they unveiled they launched WWE Network back in 2014. It was just after I had stopped watching WWE for some reason. I occasionally still watch it, like some clips here and there, but do I watch a full episode of WWE anymore? The only thing that I do, in fact, nowadays for is maybe the Royal Rumble, because I like watching that match, because it's so exciting to watch it. But yeah, not much to say about it. Oh yeah, and the Christmas party, excellent. Got a chance to see some family that I get a chance to see in a while. Some family I've never met before. Yeah, some cousins of my dad's in the family. Yeah, this is basically a smorgasbord type Christmas party. It's a Swedish one. We had a bunch of food. It was delicious, by the way. Yes, and the owner of the house is one of my dad's cousins. Yeah, it's a woman. She and her husband is French. Michel, which is French for Michael. Yes, Michael. And I think they have two kids. I think it's both girls. Yes, a couple of the cousins I met before, Mike and Timmy. These are my dad's first cousins. And I these are great people to be around. I also got a chance to hang out with my own cousin, who just a month ago got engaged. Yes, she and her boyfriend got engaged. Anyone thinking, man, you have some female cousins? Don't you have a male cousin to talk about? Yes, the cousin I went with basically on Friday was a male cousin. And he is 4 years older than I am. Yeah, he's 4 years older than I am. He's turning 37 next week. He's turning 37 next week. Yep. But yeah, great Christmas party. And then, of course, like, we were there for several hours, for at least for a few hours. My cousin put on a football game. You're probably asking, which one? It was the Cowboys versus the Jets. Yes, that was the game they put on. And you might be asking in the comments below, who won the game? I don't know. I didn't pay attention to it. I was basically talking to my family. The food was, like, yeah, I keep saying the food's excellent. We took this big picture, which, the first picture, I really liked it because it was a picture. The other one, I was not a fan of because basically it cut me out of it, which I was not personally happy with. It was done by the cousin, husband of one of my dad's cousins. Yeah, these are my grandkids' kids, who are basically around the same age as my dad. Yeah, this is the picture I have. I'm basically there, second to the left. The one on the far left, that's my cousin's fiance. My dad is next to me. Next to my dad is my aunt. And these three are his cousins. The one second from the right is my cousin, my first cousin. She's the one who got engaged. This is the one here. It was actually her house. Her name is Sue. Though people call her Sue, they call her Sue. She had no problem with it at all. The one sitting next to her, that is actually Patty. And the one with the one sitting between my aunt and Patty, her name is Peggy. And this is how they have a split level home. And here is another picture. This is of my aunt and my dad's cousin. Here's the thing. 30 degrees and he's wearing shorts. Yes, seriously. But I love the Christmas party. It was an absolutely fun experience I had. And I'd probably go back next year. Now, over the years, my dad and I have been wanting to go to the Christmas party. The problem was, and this is something on their part per se, my dad's cousins, they didn't plan this Christmas party last minute, and they sent us an invitation like less than a week in advance. Yes. Luckily enough, we had an invitation to this Christmas party back in September. Yes, 3 months ago. Yep. I actually have both my aunts there. There was another picture. I was wearing a red polo shirt. And get this, black tuxedo pants. Yes, because it was the only pair of pants I could wear because I didn't pack enough pants. No, seriously, I did not pack enough pants at all. It was cold, really cold. Luckily, I was inside a lot of the time. The only time I went outside was to get a drink. Yeah, they had wine, they had cheese. Like, let's see, what kind of food they had? Let's see, have some Swedish meatballs. Once I had Swedish meatballs, so actually gluten-free. I've never heard of gluten-free meatballs before, but that's due to one of my dad's cousins. There was some gluten-free bread. There was like 7 breads, fruit. There was this ugelags, these a Swedish log cake, which was delicious, by the way. Absolute great experience. Basically, we did some singing. Yeah, loved it. And of course, yesterday we flew back. Long flight. It felt like it took forever. Just to get off the freaking ground. Oh my gosh. Yes, it felt like it took like 20 minutes. Like, we got out, apparently the flight was delayed, so we had to get, and when we got on the plane, it felt like though it took freaking forever to get off the freaking ground. And then we get in the air, and it's a very, very relaxing flight. It's not toward the very end of the flight, it got very bumpy. Like, that was like actually about half hour before we landed. Yep. And oh, and the security both ways. When I went to Atlanta Airport, there was no line. And this is about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm like, where's the line? That would think be a little bit busy, especially since it's holiday time. Oh no, it's not that busy. Like, oh, no line. Walk straight to security. The one who's basically just show off my boarding pass and my ID. Went through security, like scanned the four things, my suitcase. There was a carry-on. Well, I thought it was a carry-on, then they had to do a courtesy carry because apparently it was too big for the carry-on thing. I'm not really sure what was up with that. Backpack, jacket, of course, normal stuff. Got that stuff in like less than a few minutes with the tram, and apparently the flight left early that day. Yes, and when we landed, it felt like that one was basically, it felt like a freaking long time for us to get to the terminal. I kept joking with the, I was joking with the passengers next to me. He's like, man, is the captain having a tough time finding a parking spot? And he was laughing at that because it was probably true. Because the captain took his sweet time getting to a freaking parking spot. Like, getting one of these terminals. Like, my gosh. This looked like, seemed like it took 15 minutes. Just to park damn plane. Then when we got back, it wasn't that bad. Not really. It felt like it took like a while. It felt like it took as long as a terminal yesterday. And I think because we went to different gate, that's why the tubes, the monorail tubes, because the O'Hare Airport's got monorails, look different. Here's a fun fact for you may not know. My dad actually worked on the monorails. He actually drove one of them back in the 90s for about a few months for Disney World. Yep, he did that. And I was telling my niece about this. She's like, really? You did that, Grandpa? And she's like, and he's like, yep, he basically worked the night shift. This was back in the 90s. Yes. And apparently the Disney World one was actually a prototype. It was actually a template for the one they used in Atlanta Airport. If you're curious though, does Tampa use this? I believe so, yes. Though in the case, the Disney World one that actually goes to a hotel for that one. But yeah, not much I'll say about this. Pretty good experience. Okay, so that's it for Circle of You. Yeah, it took a while. Next one, movie review. This one, I really want to talk about this one, okay? Next video. Bye.